Because my mum would love me talking about her, okay? She gave me my sense of humour. I'm the fruit that dropped out of that tree. We're very similar. She loved making people laugh, and she loved having a laugh. She loved to diffuse tension with a laugh. And plus, she loved being the centre of attention. She's a megalomaniac like me. We're very similar. Plus, she sat me down in front of Dave Allen and said, watch this with me, and we would laugh, and Monty Python the same. So she is responsible for me being here. So if she was in the audience, she'd love it. And then she'd be able to come back tomorrow night because she wouldn't remember a fucking thing. laugh all over again. Now, I love my mum. Mad about her. She's great. And she had a pretty tough life too. She's 84. She lives on her own still. And they become quite gnarly, pretty tough in the clinches. She was born during the Depression, raised during World War II. When she was 12, her mum died, leaving five children behind to be raised by their father, who was often absent, trying to, you know, keep a family together. Then she married young and migrated to Australia. Mum's from England. And that's a huge tumult to leave your family behind and all of your safety networks and come out here and make a life. She had three boys, and then her husband, my father, died prematurely, leaving her behind. So she's had it pretty tough, and she's gnarly. But I watch her work her way through a plate of steak and chips, and I think to myself, I should end you with a fucking house brick. Just enough is enough, okay? And that laughter is from people with aging parents. Because it's the masticating that gets you in the end, isn't it? It's like, how long are you going to take to chew that fucking mouthful? There's no power left in the jaw anymore. Little shrunken, bird-like, translucent eyelids. Just think, oh, for fuck's sake, boom! The only reason I don't slaughter my mum with a house brick is because I don't think she'd go down the first time. Seriously. And then that's quite confronting because then you're in a fight to the death with your mum in the house of your childhood, and that's some hard yards. She's like, I'm going to destroy you, Lawrence. And then you're punching one another down the hallway and all those memories. And I catch her on the chin, punch her into the lounge room. She goes over the stereo, upsets the wedding photos, smashes the priceless Wedgwood. She gets a jagged piece and opens up my face. Then we go into the kitchen. She gets the upper hand. And it's like the final page of a comic. Olive, end of volume one. She's standing over me with a brick. I created you. And now I'm going to destroy you, Lawrence. Massive blood splash. Catch Olive in volume two. She's bitten by a radioactive cockroach from her linen cupboard and learns how to fly in her. When she lands, she doesn't know where she is.